There's that vintage ad campaign, "Where's the beef?" Loved that. But our next guest wants consumers to seriously ask where their meat is coming from. Currently, meat can be labeled a, quote, product of USA, even if the animals are born, raised, and slaughtered outside of the USA, particularly in countries where there is a lower standard of food safety and worse working conditions.
Back in 2015, the country of origin labeling was repealed. Now, Senators Mike Rounds and John Thune and John Tester are supporting a measure that would mandate only beef born, raised, and slaughtered in the United States could call itself a product of the U.S. So joining us via Skype to explain more is the RCAF USA's Chief Executive Officer, Bill Bullard. He's a former cattle rancher himself. Bill, welcome back to the show. It's great to see you.
Good morning. Glad to be here.
Absolutely. So, Bill, tell us a little bit about why it's so important in order to restore real country of origin labeling for American consumers.
Well, we believe that American consumers would like to purchase the best beef in the world that's grown under the best of conditions, and that's the superior USA product. Unfortunately, when Congress repealed country of origin labeling, consumers could no longer distinguish the product produced by the American cattle farmer and rancher from the 3 billion pounds of imported product that we buy from all around the world, Costa Rica, Nicaragua, Honduras, Argentina, Uruguay, New Zealand, Australia, Canada, Mexico. And this beef comes into the United States at a much cheaper price. And then it's sold to unsuspecting consumers as if it were a product of the USA. And so consumers are continuing to pay the same price they paid for beef, roughly, for the past 5 years. Yet the income for the American rancher has fallen by one third. That means somebody in the beef supply chain has taken advantage of consumers on one end of the supply chain and producers on the other. And that needs to be corrected. And the way to correct that is to reinstate full mandatory country of origin labeling so consumers can exercise choice in the marketplace, purchase the best beef in the world, and support the American farmer and rancher.
Yeah. And so how does the rule work right now? Is it basically if it's just packaged in the U.S., it can get a Made in the USA label on it? How does that work?
Right. This was a problem that occurred actually decades ago, but was corrected when Congress first passed mandatory country of origin labeling in 2002. And the mandatory law required the imported beef product to retain its foreign label all the way through retail sale. But when Congress repealed COOL, they repealed that provision. And so the U.S. Department of Agriculture currently only requires minimal processing of an imported product in order to dispense with the foreign label and to substitute it with a product of USA label. That's highly deceptive for consumers, but it insulates the importers and the packers and allows them to make windfall profits off the back of the consumer and the American cattle rancher.
Yeah, Bill, it's hard to see this as anything other than corporate welfare. What justification did they give for trying to repeal this? It seems like an outrageous, un-American thing to do.
Well, absolutely. This is the touch of globalism. The idea was is that we would purchase beef from around the world and bring it in the United States and presume it's all the same. And so the U.S. Department of Agriculture took steps to say, well, when the imported beef crosses U.S. border and border protection, then it's to be deemed a domestic product and treated as a domestic product. And as you said, this is a corporate welfare program for the meat packers, and it insulates them from competition. And it forces the American farmer and rancher to try to compete in a global marketplace with their hands tied behind their back because they can't use the fundamental tool necessary to compete, and that's to distinguish your higher quality product in the marketplace.
Right.
So this is a huge problem costing billions of dollars to rural America.
And how has this affected cattle ranchers themselves? I mean, how are they adapting to a third loss of income? Are people having to leave the life and leave the industry?
This is a serious problem in the ranching community right now. I just came out from meetings in Missouri, and farmers and ranchers are struggling, particularly the young individuals who have tried to enter this business, and they're having a very, very difficult time because we have a cost-price squeeze. The cost of production remains high, and yet the prices that the producers are receiving has been dropping drastically. And remember, the cattle industry doesn't receive government price supports. We operate and function exclusively on a competitive marketplace. And yet Congress refuses, and the administration, both refuse to give producers the tools they need to compete in the marketplace. and that's the ability to distinguish their product with mandatory country of origin labeling. You mentioned John Tester. He introduced a resolution calling on Congress to reinstate country of origin labeling, and that's precisely what we need, and we need nothing less.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we're with you, Bill. Thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for educating us on this, Bill. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Coming up, according to a new poll, two of the top four candidates are neck and neck in the Democratic primary race.
We're going to look into the tabs of a new Emerson poll that also shows voters' commitment to supporting top-tier candidates. Team Rising is next. Stay tuned.